Afternoon YouTube. My buddy Jim over at Jim and Lori's homesteading page on Facebook came up with a brilliant idea for a quiver to store your arrows safely when you are traveling from place to place in a container that will split open and be a range arrow holder on the line when you're shooting. So for this project, I'm going to need, for these arrows, which are my longest, I'm going to need 33.5 inches, plus 3/4 inch twice is 34-35 inches. We're going to be working with 3-inch ABS pipe. We're going to take a cut off the end just to true it up. Because this piece of pipe had been cut with a sawzall before. And now we need to cut this, but I don't want to cut it exactly in half, because I want the two pieces to be the same height in appearance when it's disassembled on the range. So inch and a half off of halfway.
Nice math skills.
Nice math skills, you just screwed me right up.
Inch and a half off halfway. Seventeen and a half, 16 inches.
17.5. Here's a trick. Anybody gets stuck using a tape measure and having to find half. Well, in this case we need 35 inches. So to divide it by two, we fold the tape measure over. And then look on the inside here. And it's 17.5. So now we need 17.5 minus an inch is, or an inch and a half is 16. Is that? Shorter side. Why does that look like more than an inch and a half? What did I do? Well, I screwed it up somewhere, but it doesn't really matter that much. Just not going to be quite as pretty as I had wanted it to be.
Well, this is just a prototype.
Center of. Now you can get these center finders at any store that sells wood lathe type accessories. So make a mark one way, turn it about 90 degrees, make a mark the other way, and there's our dead center. We need that for both sides. Mark through center-ish. And there's our dead center again. Now we're using the, 17/32, I think, drill bit. One size larger than 1/4 inch.
If you're removing the deburr, wouldn't that just be burring it again?
No, it's not that cold. As a matter of fact, it's awful hot. So the hardware we're using is a pair of 1/4 inch nuts, a pair of 1/4 inch unions, a pair of 1/4 inch, 1 inch, carriage bolts, a pair of 3/8 fender washers, and a pair of 1/4 inch fender washers. And then we will be taking the head off of these 2 1/4 inch. Hey, they ripped me off. 1/4 inch by 6 inch and 1/4 inch by 5.5 inch grade 5 bolts. We'll be taking the head off and sharpening them to a point. So 3/8 nut or 3/8 fender washer, carriage bolt, 1/4 inch fender washer, Loctite. We don't want to ever have this come loose on us. There's one end cap. Another end cap. 1/4 inch fender, quarter-inch carriage bolt, 3/8-inch fender washer, through quarter-inch fender washer.
Gelatinous goo.
More gelatinous goo. Now this time, we're going to put on the union nut. Okay, now kneeling pad from the garden center section of the dollar store. Pushing the piece of pipe in left a mark. So we want to cut just a little bit proud of the inside edge of the mark. Fit into the end of the pipe. ABS adhesive. Have to excuse the mess of my workshop. My sister has moved in until she finds a place. And everything that was stored in the garage, tool-wise, has got shifted back into here. Push and twist. There's one end. Again, fit into the end of the... This one has a bit of the burr. The whole purpose of this is to keep the arrowheads from hitting the
cap.
the metal carriage bolt and the metal washer. Push and twist. This piece does not get glued together, so now the arrows travel like this. Come on. There we go. The spikes get put in the end on the ends of these. Back of the shop. Normal quarter inch nut. And Jim, if you're watching this, the Home Depot on Sevierville, those two end caps were the last two they had, or I would have bought you some too. But I do have plenty of spare pipe here for you. there. So now, in the quiver, these two can get put together and just dropped in the quiver, and they'll come out as one. They are just sort of nail sharp. They're not meant to do anything other than to stick in the dirt. But one goes in here, one goes on here, and they just get shoved into the dirt. You drop your arrows in them so you don't have to worry about screwing up your points by sticking them in the ground when you're on the archery line. You don't have to worry about having a quiver or a side quiver or anything to keep track of your arrows, or a bow quiver. This one is a pipe. We're going to just chamfer the edge a little bit. Fitting, and we're going to give it just a drop of, if I can find it, maybe not. Oh, there it is. Drop of Vaseline. Make assembly and disassembly of that pipe fitting easier. And it's that easy. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.
Irishman, Irishman, stand up and bow. You've had a good life, but it's all over now. Stand proud and stand tall. Irishman, Irishman, stand up and bow. You've had a good life, but it's all over now. Yeah, you came to this country and fought for us all. You gave me my life, so stand proud and stand tall.